I'm Carolyn Matl, a PhD student in Ruzena Bajcsy's Heart Lab at UC Berkeley, and I'll be presenting work done in collaboration with Yashraj, Narang, Fabio Ramos, and Dieter Fox at NVIDIA Seattle Robotics Lab. This work presents a software and hardware framework that automatically calibrates a physics simulator to accurately simulate granular media. Specifically, granular material simulation parameters are inferred from real-world depth images of granular formations. Now, a granular material is broadly defined as a collection of discrete macroscopic particles that interact primarily through frictional contact and inelastic collisions. Naturally, this definition spans a wide range of familiar materials, such as sand, nuts, and cereal grains. And as abundant as they are in our daily lives, they're just as prevalent, in fact, they're one of the most manipulated substances, in robotics-integrated industries. Think of agriculture robots scattering seeds, terrain-traversing robots scaling mounds of gravel, and pharmaceutical robots sorting through pills. At NVIDIA's Seattle Robotics Lab, we've been particularly interested in manipulating granular media in human collaborative applications, such as pouring rice, coffee beans, or corn in a kitchen setting. And while many of our daily tasks require us to manipulate grains, it's challenging to predict how these materials may behave in unseen scenarios under dynamic interactions with a robot. Due to the complexity of granular physics, both roboticists and granular physicists have leveraged discrete element method, or DEM, simulation to model these interactions. DEM is a popular numerical technique for simulating each grain as an individual particle. However, most methods to calibrate DEM material parameters involve a tedious cycle of performing small-scale material tests or iteratively and manually tuning parameters until realistic granular behavior is captured. This work aims to reduce this burden by introducing an efficient framework to infer particle scale parameters, such as frictional properties, from macroscale behavior, such as granular pile shape. Specifically, the main contributions of this work are a software and hardware framework that integrates an efficient physics simulator, depth images of granular formations, and likelihood-free Bayesian inference to estimate particle-scale material properties, a demonstration of the use of this framework to calibrate material properties of agricultural grains for a simulator, which is then evaluated against new scenarios in simulation and experiment, and then finally, a robotic demonstration that uses the proposed framework to reason about agricultural grains in order to complete a simple manipulation task. The proposed framework is built upon the following simplifications and assumptions. Simulated grains are represented by rigid, cohesionless spheres of uniform size and mass, and all easily measurable features, such as diameter and mass, serve as inputs to the simulator. The parameters we chose as our variables of interest are the coefficients of restitution, sliding friction, and rolling friction. These parameters contribute to the energy dissipation of the grains upon contact, and in turn, their dynamics and steady state. Together, these three material parameters enable the simulator to generate a diversity of realistic granular behavior. The framework thus aims to infer these parameters, which we denote by theta, from a single bird's eye view depth image of the grains at steady state. The particular steady state signal we use is the depth image of the granular formation that is created when the grains are poured through a funnel onto a flat surface. We match this experimental setup in simulation and in the real world. While our inference method is simulator agnostic, we chose to model contact as a nonlinear complementarity problem solved implicitly using a GPU-optimized non-smooth Newton solver in the NVIDIA Isaac simulator platform. This enabled both high accuracy and rapid simulation of 2,000 spherical grains. Meanwhile, for physical experiments, the funnel was positioned to match the simulated experimental setup, and black velvet covered the ground surface to limit the spread of the grains upon impact. An Intel RealSense D435 depth camera was positioned at a bird's eye viewpoint over the ground surface, and an ABB Yumi dual arm robot was used for the later robot experiments. From the resulting high-dimensional depth image of the granular formation, which we denote by X, we extract a vector of summary statistics, or T of X, which essentially summarizes the shape of the granular formation with scalar values. Most DEM calibration work relies on extracting specific features, such as angle of repose of a conical pile, in order to infer a single parameter. Taking a more generalizable approach, we propose using a vector of 16 summary statistics to capture the general shape of the granular formation, chosen to summarize the dispersion and statistical dependence of the grain locations. Now, the likelihood function that we're interested in computing, or the conditional density of observed summary statistics given material parameters, is often intractable to evaluate. So we therefore chose to use a likelihood-free inference approach, or Bayesian, to approximate the posterior of parameters given real observations. More specifically, Bayesian directly learns a conditional density function by learning from pairs of parameters and summary statistics. These pairs are generated by independently sampling parameters from a predefined prior distribution and then forward simulating each sample. Summary statistics are then extracted from the forward simulations. Now, let's say we have an observation, X super R, for which we would like to infer simulator parameters. The posterior is then parametrically approximated using the learned conditional density and the summary statistics of that observation, T of X super R. We first tested this framework on simulated data. Given a simulated depth image, we wanted to test the accuracy of the inferred parameters. Forward simulation of the inferred parameters were run, and comparing the granular formation side by side, they visually looked equivalent and quantitatively shared similar summary statistics. Simulation-to-simulation comparisons also enabled a principled approach to testing sensitivity to model error. For instance, one interesting result was that spherical approximations used to represent grains in simulation could compensate reasonably well for differences in geometry by varying the three material parameters of interest. Once we were satisfied with the performance of the framework for inferring simulation material parameters from simulated depth images, we transitioned to testing whether the framework could calibrate the simulator to represent real agricultural grains like couscous and barley. Indeed, forward simulation with the estimated parameters captured similar macroscopic behavior. This was an exciting result, but it was critical to test how well these parameters generalized to pores at different heights. Thus, five more heights were tested for each grain, and for each of these pores, forward simulation was run with the same inferred granular parameters. By comparing the simulated and real granular formations, we saw that the inferred parameters generalized reasonably well for both couscous and barley. The encouraging results from the real-world to simulation calibration experiments suggested that it may be possible under this framework to enable an industrial robot to pour granular material into a desired shape. So using the inferred material parameters of couscous, we trained a new Bayesian model to infer the required funnel height to form a desired ring or pile shape. Three funnel heights were then inferred, corresponding to a desired pattern of two concentric rings with an inner pile. The robot was then commanded to pour couscous from these heights, resulting in the desired pattern. Finally, while the proposed inference framework relies on static images of grains at steady state, we wanted to test how closely it could match the behavior of grains under more dynamic conditions. For instance, can we use the presented framework to predict undesirable spilling during a granular pouring task? Couscous and barley were poured into a cereal bowl at different heights by the industrial robot, and an equivalent setup was recreated in the calibrated simulator. In most cases, the calibrated simulator predicted the number of spilled grains across different pouring heights with surprising accuracy. So to conclude, in this work, the simulation material parameters of granular materials were inferred using a new framework combining likelihood-free Bayesian inference, efficient simulation, and simple experiments. The use of GPU-based simulation and off-the-shelf depth cameras may be particularly appealing for robotics applications. Robotics demos showed that the inferred parameters of grains like couscous and barley generalized well to different pouring heights, and a robot can effectively reason about granular material to pour desired granular formations and predict its behavior in dynamic scenarios. Future directions for this work include replacing static image observations with temporal sequences of depth images and modeling cohesion to allow for liquid-solid interactions. Finally, more elaborate robotic manipulation tasks can be explored, such as pouring grains into and out of assorted containers. For more experimental details, please see the paper. If feel free to contact me at my email or via the provided Slack workspace for questions and comments about this paper. And thank you so much for your interest in our work.